Good morning to all of you. I am Ramakrishna from Keele University, delivering series of lessons on heat transfer. Today, we will look into heat transfer through composite spheres. The last class we have seen heat transfer through composite cylinders. In the same way, we have heat transfer through composite spheres. This topic belongs to one-dimensional steady-state heat conduction without internal heat generation through a cylinder or spheres. At the end of this session, the student will be able to understand what is a composite sphere, how to consider equivalent electrical network for a composite sphere, and how to evaluate the heat transfer through a composite sphere, and what is critical radius of insulation for a sphere, and how to estimate the critical radius of insulation in a sphere. So let us see one by the other. A composite sphere is nothing but a sphere with layers of insulation added on it. For example, consider a sphere of radius R1, maybe hot when compared to the environment. So from the surface of the sphere, heat will be lost into the environment. To avoid that heat lost, imagine this is covered with three layers of insulation. Or, in other way, consider a hollow sphere having radius R1, inner radius, and outer radius R2. Now, the heat has to flow from the inner surface to the outer surface. So, the material itself offers some amount of resistance. This sphere is now added with two insulation, so total you have three resistances. This kind of sphere with more number of layers offering resistance for heat transfer is known as a composite sphere. So let us consider now a sphere of inside radius R1 and outside radius R2. This is added with two layers of insulation, one having thermal conductivity K2, another having thermal conductivity K3. So when you add a layer of thermal conductivity K2 on the sphere, the radius increases from R2 to R3. When you add another layer of insulation K3 on the sphere, the radius increases from R3 to R4. Now observe, thickness of the first layer of insulation is R3 minus R2. Thickness of second layer of insulation is R4 minus R3. And thickness of the sphere is R2 minus R1. Imagine the inside surface of the sphere is hot at T1 temperature, and the outer surface of the second layer of insulation is T4. And let the interface temperatures be T2 and T3. So we have four temperatures, T1, T2, T3 and T4. Now for the heat flow through the inner surface to the outer surface, there are three resistances acting one after the other. The first one is resistance offered by the sphere material. The second one is the resistance offered by the insulating material 1, and the third one is resistance offered by the insulating material 2. Because these three are acting in series, the total resistance offered for conduction heat transfer from T1 to T4 is R sphere plus R insulation 1 plus R insulation 2. And we have seen in the fundamental classes, the resistance formula for a sphere is 1 by 4 pi k, 1 by initial radius minus 1 by outer radius. So it is for sphere 1 by 4 pi k1, 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. And for this insulation 1, the thermal conductivity is k2, so 1 by 4 pi k2, and this insulation 2 is applied from radius r2 to r3, so 1 by r2 minus 1 by r3. And the third insulating layer resistance is 1 by 4 pi k3, it is from r3 to r4, so 1 by r3 minus 1 by r4. Now once you know the total resistance, the rate of heat transfer from T1 to T4 is delta T by R total, that is T1 minus T4 by R total. You will get the total heat transfer. Suppose you consider convective heat transfer boundary inside and convective heat transfer boundary outside also. Imagine H naught here, HI are given. So when convective heat transfer coefficients are given, you have to consider the resistance offered for convection also. So in addition to these three conduction resistances, you will have one inside convective resistance offered by the inside fluid and outside convective resistance offered by the environment fluid. So altogether you will have five resistances. One inside convective resistance, next conduction resistance of the sphere material, next conduction resistance of the insulating layer 1, and next conduction resistance of the insulating layer 2, and finally outside convective resistance. And the formula for convective resistance is 1 by HA. So for inside convective resistance, it is 1 by HIAI plus same thing, 1 by 4 pi K1, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Next insulation resistance 1, 1 by 4 pi K2 into 1 by R2 minus 1 by R3. Next insulation resistance 2, 1 by 4 pi K3 into 1 by R3 minus 1 by R4 plus outside convective resistance 1 by H naught A naught, where AI is equal to 4 pi R1 square, surface area of the inner sphere, and A naught is the 4 pi R4 square. So by knowing A naught, A1, K1, K2, R1, R2, R3, R4, you can determine the R total. Again, the formula is Q equal to now inside temperature minus outside temperature by R total. You understand? So therefore, if convective heat transfer coefficients are not given in the place, directly you know the temperatures at the surface, you can take only conduction resistance. If the fluid temperature inside the sphere is given along with the inside convective heat transfer coefficient, which is makes a sense that the fluid temperature and wall temperature will never be same, there exists a convective resistance also, and you have to consider that convective resistance. Let us quickly have a look at problem. A spherical reactor vessel containing liquid refrigerant at 5 degrees centigrade inside is insulated so that the heat rejection should not be more than 400 watts condition. So what should be the thickness of insulating material required with reference to the data given below? The inner radius of the sphere is 4 meters and outer radius is 4.1 meters. Thermal conductivity of the sphere material is 0.2 watt, 25 watt per meter Kelvin, and thermal conductivity of the insulating material is 0.2 watt per meter Kelvin. The surroundings are at 35 degrees centigrade and assume negligible convective resistance inside and outside the vessel. Very important. Negligible convective resistance. When the resistance is negligible, that is zero, there won't be any temperature difference. Hence, the surrounding temperature is 35 means surface temperature is also 35. Liquid refrigerant temperature is 5 degrees means inside surface temperature is also 5 degrees. It is because you are given to neglect the convective resistances inside and outside. So now between T1 and T3, you see, first you have the wall of the sphere and then you have the insulation. The heat starts flowing from 35 degrees centigrade to 5 degrees in this direction. See this way. From right to left. The first resistance offered for conduction heat transfer is the insulating layer. The next resistance offered is the sphere material. So, the heat has to flow first through the insulation and then through the sphere. Before insulation, the temperature is 35 degrees, that is T3, and after the pipe wall, the temperature is 5 degrees. So, two resistances are acting in series, because heat has to flow first through the insulation and then through the pipe, one after the other, so both of them act in series. Now Q equal to delta T by R total, and R total is R sphere plus R insulation. The formula for sphere resistance is 1 by 4 pi thermal conductivity of the sphere K1 into radius of the sphere, inner R1, outer R2, so 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So take LCM, you will get R2 minus R1 by 4 pi K1 R1 R2. In the same way, the insulation resistance for the sphere is 1 by 4 pi K2 1 by R2 minus 1 by R3. So it also takes this form, R3 minus R2 by 4 pi K2 R2 R3. Now Q equal to delta T by R total. R total is equal delta T by Q. So R total means sum of these two, R2 minus R1 by 4 pi K1 R1 R2 plus R3 minus R2 by 4 pi K2 R2 R3 equal to delta T by Q. Delta T between these two nodes, 35 minus 5 Q, it is limited to 4000 watts equal to 4000, and you know R1 inner radius of the sphere is 4 meters and you know the outer radius 4.1. And we don't know the thickness of the insulation, so R3 is unknown. R3 minus 4.1. So unknown is only R3. If you solve this equation, you will get R3 value 4.44 meters. So 4.1 to 4.34 meters means roughly 34 centimeters of thickness insulation you have to add on the spear to minimize or to have a heat loss less than 4000 watts. Suppose you are asked to determine the interface temperature, say Ti. How to find Q is equal to T3 minus Ti by R insulation over. Or you can also find Q is equal to Ti minus 5 between these two divided by R sphere. Anyway, we can try. Let us move to the next topic, critical thickness of insulation for sphere. Just like in cylinders, in case of sphere also, we experience an increase in heat transfer initially when we add insulation, and then it starts decreasing gradually. Without insulation, let us see, the radius of the sphere is R1. So therefore, the area available for convection from this surface is 4 pi R1 square. If you add insulation, the outer surface area increases to 4 pi R2 square. Because of increase in surface area, it may convect more amount of heat into the environment. So adding of insulation in case of sphere may increase the heat transfer under certain circumstances instead of decreasing it. Let us say the analysis. You consider a sphere of radius R1 covered with an insulating material having thermal conductivity K. Let the surface temperature of the sphere is T1. And the insulation surface temperature is T2. So now for the heat transfer to flow through this and from the surface into the environment at T alpha, there are two resistances acting. Heat first flows from the surface through the insulation by means of conduction, and then it enters into the environment by means of convection. This conduction and convection occurs simultaneously, I mean one after the other. First it passes through the insulating layer and then it enters into the environment. So it occurs one after the other in series. So therefore total resistance is equal to sum of the conduction resistance and convective resistance. And as we know, the conduction resistance for this sphere is 1 by 4 pi K1, where K1 is the thermal conductivity of the insulating medium, into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Plus the convective resistance 1 by H0 A0, where A0 is 4 pi R2 square. Carefully follow, the first resistance represents the conduction resistance offered by the insulating material. And the second resistance indicates the convective resistance. As you go on adding insulation on the sphere, R2 value goes on increases. As R2 increases, the negative term decreases, and hence the conduction resistance increases. Carefully follow. As R2 increases, that means as we go on adding insulation, the conduction resistance increases. As R2 increases, the denominator increases here, so convective resistance decreases. So with increase in radius, conduction resistance increases, convective resistance decreases. Same thing happens in a cylinder also. Therefore, it is of our interest to identify at which value of R2 the rate of heat transfer will reach maximum. So let us differentiate the Q with respect to R2 and equate to 0. Delta T divided by minus of delta T divided by minus of this entire denominator whole square into, again, derivative of this term, that is 1/4πk1 into 1/r1 derivative is 0 because r1 is constant, minus 1/r2 derivative is plus 1/r2 square, and 1/4πh0 is constant, 1/r2 square derivative is minus 2/r2 cube equal to 0. So bring the negative terms to the right hand side, you will get R2 equal to 2k/h0, or the critical radius of insulation for us is given by the formula 2k/h0. Did you remember? The critical thickness of insulation for a cylinder is k/h0, but for a sphere it is 2k/h0. This is what happens. So critical radius is equal to RC equal to 2k/h0. Similar to a cylindrical problem, on the sphere also, as you go on increasing its radius, first up to certain time, the rate of heat transfer increases and then it starts decreasing. The point where you have maximum heat transfer and the corresponding radius is known as critical radius, which indicates that on the left side of the critical radius, you have convection resistance decrement is more than the conduction resistance increment, so rate of heat transfer increases. It nullifies at the maximum point, and beyond this, the conduction resistance starts dominating the convective resistance, and hence adding insulation will reduce the heat transfer. And the formula for the critical radius of sphere is given by 2k/h0. And once you know the critical radius, the thickness of insulation is RC minus R1. So if the radius of the sphere with insulation is less than RC, or even without insulation is less than RC, adding insulation will increase the heat transfer. If the radius is more than RC, adding insulation will reduce the heat transfer. So this is the concept of critical thickness of insulation, similar to critical thickness of insulation for a cylinder. So when you want to reduce the heat transfer from a spherical system, you have to verify whether adding that insulation will reduce it or increase it before applying it. Let us quickly have a look at one or two problems. a 5 millimeter diameter spherical ball at 50 degrees centigrade is covered by 1 mm thick plastic coating. The ball is exposed to medium at 15 degrees centigrade with a combined conduction, convection and radiation heat transfer coefficient of 20 watt per meter square Kelvin. Determine whether the plastic coating increase the heat transfer or decrease from the surface of the ball. Now, the first step, the moment you see the word critical, or in case of sphere and cylinders, whether you want to check the heat transfer increases or decreases, the problem is pertaining to a critical radius of insulation. Hence, first step is draw this figure, Q versus R. Mark y-axis and mark x-axis, Q and R. And then immediately draw this profile. Heat transfer first increases, reaches a maximum, and then starts decreasing. The maximum point and corresponding radius is known as critical radius. The problem is a spherical problem. So the formula for critical radius is 2k by h naught, where k is the thermal conductivity of the insulate material, not the sphere material, where k is the thermal conductivity of the material added on the sphere to avoid heat transfer. So thermal conductivity is 0.13, 2 into 0.13 by 20, 0.013 meter, that is 13 mm. So mark here RC equal to 13 mm. I will again repeat. Before calculating RC, first draw the graph, y-axis, x-axis, mark Q, R, and then this profile, parabolic profile, and mark the maximum point as RC. Now calculate RC, you got 13 mm, mark here RC equal to 13 mm. Let us now come back to the problem. What is the sphere diameter given? 5 mm. But this axis is radius. So you convert the diameter into radius, it is 2.5 mm. This 2.5 mm lies on the left hand side of the critical radius, because this point is 13, 2.5 is maybe here. Now it is covered with 1 mm thick plastic coating. So 2.5 mm will become 3.5 mm. Original diameter is 2.5. Now it is covered by 1 mm thick plastic coating, so it becomes 3.5. So the point moves from R1 to R2, 2.5 to 3.5 on the left hand side of critical radius, so rate of heat transfer increases. So applying plastic coating on the ball increases the rate of heat transfer. That is how you have to confirm. So the important point in this is adding insulation. Here this plastic coating is an insulating material having the low thermal conductivity. Adding insulation never guarantees the decrement in heat transfer, particularly in case of cylinders and spheres. You don't have such problem in slabs. Why? In case of slab, the area will not change. As you go on adding insulation, the convective resistance remains same, conduction resistance goes on increases, because the surface area is not changing. Convective resistance remains same, conduction resistance goes on increases, so total resistance goes on increases, the curve is always dropping, negative slope, it reduces with increase in radius. But whereas in spheres and cylinders, adding insulation increase the radius and thereby increase the exposed surface area, hence the convective resistance decreases. So until that convective resistance is offset, by the increase in conduction resistance, you have the dominance of convective resistance, and heat transfer goes on, increases till that point. That point where it reaches maximum, we call it as critical radius. So that's all about the heat transfer through the composite cylinders. Thank you very much.